So, without further ado, someone who wanted to make sure I announced to you is America's outstanding mom, Mary Tomko.
I have no idea if I'm on.
No.
Is this thing not working?
No.
Nope. Okay, let's get ready. Get me something.
I might be able to turn it off.
Okay. Anyway, well, first of all, I want to thank you. Pardon me. I guess so. I need my PowerPoint, if that's okay.
Yes.
I want to thank Gigi for going through all this trouble to get us all out here. I feel like I'm among the most incredible minds. Right? Should I just use the handheld? I can do that. Hold on, folks. Let's get this thing off of me. I'm all hooked up here. Okay. I'll take the handheld. Oh, it's tied down. Oh, boy. Okay. It won't be picked up, although. It's seriously tied down. Can you? Oh, I have no mind about that. Can we get this closer? I don't know how I'm going to do this.
You click.
I will click. You tell me to click and I'll click.
Oh, boy. This is going to be fun. Okay. First of all, what is America's Outstanding Mom? It is an organization that addresses mothers in the country, and I'll tell you what, my daughter put my name in without my knowledge. When I was told I was the Michigan delegate, I was like, this is some kind of joke, right? Little did I know it was a full-blown pageant where I had to go and do the whole pageant with judges and everything else. Next slide. But anyway, she did it because I have a mission. I'm on a mission to educate parents and the society about autism. And so my whole purpose of doing this is to reach another crowd, another group of people who didn't know who I am or what I'm all about. So that's really why my daughter put my name in. And I was just so honored to be chosen as America's Outstanding Mom. My reign goes until next July. So in the meantime, if you're going to have a conference or an event, please consider bringing me out. My sponsor, Avena Originals, is the group that is paying for my flight and my hotels. Normally, you would have to pay that, so they're going to save you probably $1,500. So if you have a conference or an event, I usually do about a 3 or 4 hour presentation on the whole issue of vaccines, autism, and other related topics. So please, sponsor me. My platform, as I said, is Heart for Autism, and I'm just honored to represent moms around the country. Now, let me take this off and put on my research hat, okay? Let's get down to business. Because you guys came here to learn, or to hear about vaccinations, and we know that it is probably the biggest medical crisis facing our children in the country right now. So, next slide. You can keep going. That's our Heart for Autism. You can meet up with me, by the way, on Facebook. I have a radio program every Saturday, and my website is Childhood Shots. You're going to get real tired. So we're going to talk about vaccines, what I call an organized assault. And this is a new take, but I thought you guys could handle this. Normally, I wouldn't be putting this out there for moms and dads, but I really believe. And people say, well, Mary, why do you do this? Do you have children with autism, or are they vaccine injured? And the answer is no. I have 5 very healthy, grown adult children who never had a vaccine, never had a prescription filled. You see, back in the 70s, I did research before I had my first child. And my husband, my ex-husband and I, raised our children outside the medical model. We never had a pediatrician. We never filled a prescription. We never bought over-the-counter meds. I had home births with midwives. And I also home-educated my kids. So you see, we can't do it, even though we're busy, right? 2 of my daughters are now chiropractors, and they're carrying the torch. My children are all nuts that didn't fall far from my tree. So it's a good thing, right? But I do it because I believe every child in America, in the world, should come into this world and have an opportunity to be healthy. And that's not what's going on in this country. I do it because I know how wonderful it is to have healthy children. And even life is still hard with healthy kids. Imagine what it's like when you have children that are sick with asthma, learning disabilities, autism. They can't eat anything, food allergies, and that's what's going on in this country. Next slide. They are our future. If we do not make quantum changes now for our children, it's not even, you know, I'm a home-based education person, but these kids can't even learn because they're neurologically so offended by the vaccinations. Parents are confused. They're lost. They don't know who to listen to. People call me the Erin Brockovich of this industry because I'm not a doctor. I'm an independent researcher who has a passionate mission. Just as Erin Brockovich was not an attorney, but she was responsible for the largest class action lawsuit to ever hit this country. I have been doing this since 1994 because I believe parents need the truth, and that's what it's all about, is the truth. So I try to help them work through the confusion and try to send them places where they can get research and information so they can make an informed decision. George Shaw said, of all the antisocial vested interests, the worst is the vested interest in ill health, and that's exactly what we have going on. There is a childhood crisis. A professor from the University of Toronto said, there are those who would predict that in this generation of children, the parents are going to be the first to outlive their children if this trend isn't reversed. Can you imagine burying your children? These young generations right now, these mommies, could very possibly be burying their children before they die. The chronic pediatric conditions, and I'm sorry this is hard to read, autism, 1 in 50 children, 1 in 38 boys. ADHD, more than 11% of boys have it. Asthma, 10% of our children are on asthma medication daily. Eczema, 20% of children. That is an autoimmune problem. Depression in kids. Depression. Childhood is supposed to be a time of happiness and no stress and carefree and innocence. And yet we have 5 to 10-year-olds now, the suicide rate climbs 10% every year from depression and meds from depression. Allergies, 50% of American children. Right now, 20 million children are affected some way. I believe that vaccines are a software installation of disease. We are bioengineering these things in laboratories and injecting them. By the way, if you've heard me before, please raise your hand. Well, this is great. I've got a lot of new people there. Have you seen my DVD, Are Vaccines Safe? No. Well, mine was one of the first to hit the market back in, you know, several years ago. And please, when you get my DVD and share it with people, you're helping this movement tremendously. But, you know, this all goes back to our understanding of the immune system. You see, modern medicine, even though they look and think and act like they know a lot, they really know very little about immunity. And parents will never understand the damage of vaccines if they don't understand that we know hardly anything about the immune system. But there was some new research that came out in the 80s. And it was because of the AIDS research. And they said the focus of science has shifted from a separate entity of the immune system to an interactive immune model. They actually believed, before 1980, that the immune system was this little pocket somewhere in the body that was isolated and had autonomy. Seriously, that's what was in the textbooks. They believed that the only thing that would be affected by a vaccine was this little compartment in the body. That's like saying if you eat an apple, the only thing affected is your stomach. So they had this new awareness, next slide. And then Pasteur Institute also said 98% of the immune response comes from the non-specific immune system. Vaccinations do not affect this part of the body. And I know this is heavy, and I have 100 and something slides, so I'm gonna skip past some of this. But they found out that the nervous system and the immune system are intricately connected and dance together in this beautiful rhythm. And that if you affect the nervous system, you actually affect the immune system. And if you do something in the immune system, you affect neurological development. So they discovered that the two of these things work intricately together throughout the body. They actually had to rewrite the university textbooks in 1995. You know what that tells me? Everything before that was wrong. Vaccinations have been around for about 150 years. We started using them on a mass scale in the 1950s, and they are based on a wrong presupposition. They are non-scientific. They are based on an outdated theory that even modern immunologists will tell you is false. So, next slide. If something is based on a false presupposition, it is wrong. Do you agree?
Absolutely.
It's not based in truth. And yet the whole vaccine policy in this country and around the world is based on our outdated concept of the human body and the immune system. Every bit of it is flawed science. If you change, and vaccines by injection, when you inject a vaccination, you change the timing of a person's exposure to that illness. When would a brand new baby get exposed to hepatitis B, a disease that is common among prostitutes and drug users, and it's the first shot they give them in the hospital for sexually transmitted illnesses? When would a child ever be exposed to that? So we are changing the timing that a child will be exposed. We are acting as though we no better than God, our creator, and we know how to do something to improve the human body. We change the method. By nature, children are exposed to illnesses through their nose, their mouth, their lungs, not by injection. Next slide. So in vaccinology, also, their gold standard is the measurement of titers. And they always say, well, we have to check you for titers. You can hit that button again. But actually, the measurement of titers, now we understand, is a sign of chronic ongoing inflammation. It's not a good thing if you have really high titers to measles or chickenpox or mumps. It means that that child's body is in a state of hyperimmunity. So when they talk about titers, again, it's based on that old garbage science. Next slide. Vaccinations go completely against how nature would intend us to build natural immunity. Can you guys see any of that print? Do you know, I just changed it. I had it white before this talk, and I thought you wouldn't be able to see it. My mistake. Anyway, there are no long-term safety studies on vaccinations. Zero. None. When they say they're fully safety studied, they're lying to you. And my normal four-hour presentation, I give you all the research and all the references. But right now, we don't have time for that. They are a human experiment that has lasted about the last 100 years. Three generations now are involved. We are changing humanity on a chromosome level unlike never before done in the history of mankind. Just so you know, immunity starts the baby's developing at about the fifth week in utero. The immune system begins to develop and T cells begin to be made. And so this whole concept that a baby is completely incapable from an immune system point of view is not based on truth. And basically what happens is the Th1 arm of the immune system is developing in mom with that baby, but it's suppressed because mom and baby can't fight each other. But the very birth process is when the baby's immune system is sparked to life. Next slide. Things that can interfere with normal natural immune development are drugs during pregnancy. We give mom Tylenol with acetaminophen like it's candy. We inject them with flu vaccinations and other vaccines while they're pregnant. We're encouraging them to take medications that before were taboo while moms are pregnant. We have alcohol and tobacco use we know affects unborn children. The use of acetaminophen. Do you know about acetaminophen? Go to my website, on my front page, childhoodshots.com. On there I have a whole report. Acetaminophen is the active ingredient in Tylenol. And it is put in 91 other medications, and it suppresses the immune system. It shuts down 5 metabolic pathways in the brain that do not allow you to detox, and they're giving it to children like it's candy. There are thousands of babies who die every year from liver toxicity due to acetaminophen. It is the number one reason people go to the hospital with liver failure. So do not use anything with acetaminophen, and please do not give it to your babies. There are other ways that you can deal with pain, okay? Antibiotic use. Antibiotics wipe out mom's good flora and cause yeast and bacterial problems before that baby is even born, setting that child up for problems, chemical exposures, and of course, vaccines during pregnancy and post-birth. These are all things that interfere with normal immune development. And then if a mother drinks, we know we're not supposed to do that. We know we're not supposed to cigarettes. But it's okay to give you a vaccine laced with mercury and aluminum, right? Next slide. Babies have something called the blood-brain barrier. It's there to protect our brain from things that we might get exposed to. That barrier does not protect the whole brain. There are certain parts of the brain that are never protected. And that barrier is not in place for up to 6 weeks after a baby is born. So do you think it's smart to be injecting bioengineered toxins, aluminum, mercury, phenol, acetone, formaldehyde in the vaccinations that can get up into that brain?
No.
Okay. So keep going. There's a lot of research now. This just came out in 2009, Pediatric Bioscience. When you see BBB, it's referencing the blood-brain barrier. It says the blood-brain barrier permeability can change as a result of many factors, including subclinical infection, exposure to environmental toxins, addictive drugs, extreme stress, and possibly some medications. Some bacteria and viruses have become adept at breaching this barrier. Next slide. They go on to say there is now growing evidence that neuroimmune crosstalk may even occur in non-disease conditions, including the healthy brain. So the nervous system and the immune system are talking all the time and communicating and driving neurodevelopment in the brain and also driving immune development. Next slide. They went on in this study to say the immune system can be considered as a diffuse sensory organ, which works in concert with the nervous system to achieve and maintain homeostasis throughout the body. And so imagine this. They know this science now. It's in the journals. The pediatricians, if they're reading the journals, are aware of this. But they do these injections regardless of the fact that way these things can get into a child's brain. Natural exposure, when we get exposed, is through the mouth, nose, the mucous membranes. When babies are crawling around on the floor at the age of three or four or five or six or eight months, they're picking up things and putting it in their mouth constantly. Their feet go in their mouth from the very beginning when they can finally get into their mouth. It's because that's how their immune system says, teach me about your environment. Babies need to put things in their mouth. They need to be exposed to their environment. And that's how they build natural immunity. You see, God didn't make any mistakes. And by the way, breastfeeding and the birth process are very, very integral to developing healthy immunity. That's why babies who are put on formula, which by the way, read the ingredient. Next time you go into a store, go into the formula, pull it out, you're gonna see 42% high fructose corn syrup is the number one ingredient in formulas given to babies. We are destroying their brains, okay? Millions of times a day, a newborn is responding to their environment and their immune system is reacting. Next slide. Every human is unique. Babies are born differently. Some have genetic strengths or weaknesses. The quality of prenatal care can determine a lot. There's a difference between a mom who eats organic and takes care of herself while she's pregnant and the mom who's growing up feeding herself on McDonald's and Taco Bell. Okay? There's fetal exposure to toxins pre-birth, traumatic birth process, birth weight and function of birth, and then every child develops differently. And yet, vaccinations are a one-size-fits-all. Every child, no matter how strong, weak, premature, not, they are all given the same vaccinations. Next slide. So what happens at birth? Next slide. These beautiful babies come out and they're just taking their first breath of life and they're given a hepatitis B vaccination. These vaccines cause immune dysfunction and into deficiency. They cause hypersensitivity, which is an overreaction to their body, to their parts, an inappropriate reaction towards their self, inflammation. We have a serious problem with brain inflammation, gut inflammation, lung inflammation. All of these illnesses are forms of inflammation. And this is exactly what we're doing. Next slide. I'm talking fast, you guys, because I don't want you to miss one bit of this, okay? This is just a study that talks about as the B cells that make antibodies in the body increase, activated by the adjuvants in the vaccines, and I'll tell you what an adjuvant is in just a moment, but all vaccinations have adjuvants. But when they're activated by the adjuvants of vaccines, the T cells, which are responsible for cell-based immunity and cell memory, decrease. So we are literally shutting down and suppressing the normal immune reaction that we would have to any infectious illness. Cell memory is critical for long-term immune development, and that is why vaccinated people are unprotected. Period. They're the ones, by the way, who are having the whooping cough outbreak. It's not the vaccinated. Don't be deceived. Don't be fooled. We now know the mechanism of injury. We are creating these new illnesses. The hyperactivity of the B cell makes autoantibodies that attack different tissue, causing allergies, Crohn's disease, colitis, juvenile diabetes, and other autoimmune problems, which depending on the target or tissue. Every child is unique. We never know how these vaccines are going to affect them. Most of these problems appear in children who undergo heavy vaccine programs. Many of our veterans also have highly vaccinated and have neurological problems. Next slide. Dr. Stephen Marini, I reference him a lot. He's an immunologist, PhD biologist, and a chiropractor. And this is his quote, vaccines by injection elicit a wrong response and do nothing to enhance or help non-specific immunity. Vaccines impair function. Post-birth insult number one, I mentioned the hepatitis B vaccination. By the way, we all know the toxicity of aluminum. I'm gonna cover just a little bit about it, but babies get the hep B vaccination. That vaccination, by the way, suppresses Th2 suppresses the Th1 arm, increases Th2, which is where hyperimmune response comes from. Babies go in every 2 months for repeated immunizations, which drastically continue to suppress Th1, and that's why our children have all these immune problems. Next slide. The well baby visit at 2 months, a baby is going to go in and get anywhere from 6 to 8 vaccinations in one visit. And by the way, I never had a pediatrician. My children never saw a pediatrician. I never had a medical doctor. We raised our children with chiropractic, healthy, or back then we didn't have organic, but I was one of those moms who, you know, was slaving in the kitchen all the time. We did everything we could to promote health naturally. The biggest thing I did was avoided all the medical garbage they want to put down our children's throat and in their veins, right? Yeah. That's the biggest thing. oftentimes it's more about what not to do to your children. We have to protect them from that world out there. Anyway, they'll get 26 to 38 different vaccines by the time they are 18 months. Never before done in use in history. Next slide. A fact about the immune system, nothing can strengthen the human body by avoidance, only by overcoming challenges. We learn and develop by challenging ourselves. A baby goes from crawling to walking by challenging their body. And the immune system is no different. It has to be challenged and exercised for it to develop. Next slide. Several immunologists are now writing books, and I'm not going to go into a lot of this, but Dr. Tatiana, she's a PhD from right here, New York Rockefeller University, and this is what she said as an immunologist. She actually took a break to have a baby and decided to do some research. She says, quote, after years of doing research in immunology, observing scientific activities of my superiors, and analyzing vaccine issues, I realized that vaccination is one of the most deceptive inventions that science could ever convince the world to accept. Next slide. She says, if the committees at the National Institutes have decided that it is politically incorrect to study vaccine injuries, then they will turn down any grant applications that propose to do that, no matter how well scientifically justified. Okay? It's all fraud. And her book is called The Vaccine Illusion. Go online, get it at wherever. It's an awesome book. If you know, if you have a mommy in your family, a young niece or nephew, go get them a gift. Take it to baby showers, whatever. Get them something to educate them about vaccinations, because you could be literally saving their life and their family. Next slide. Adjuvants. What's an adjuvant? An adjuvant is added to a vaccination to cause an ongoing reaction in the human body and in the immune system for days and days after the vaccine is given. It's an irritant. It's unnatural. They're synthetic. They're not good. You wouldn't eat them. But aluminum is the most commonly used one. How many of you are aware that thimerosal and vaccinations was a big mercury thing, and that's why we all talk about vaccines now? Well, they had to reduce it because of public pressure. Not because they're nice people, but because of public pressure, they had to reduce it. And now they're telling everyone they're thimerosal free. Well, they had to put a different adjuvant in, so they threw in aluminum. Well, we know aluminum is no good. We know not to cook with it. We know to avoid using it in deodorants. We know to avoid aluminum foil, right, and all these things. Well, they now use aluminum as the number one adjuvant, not only in vaccines, but over-the-counter meds and prescription drugs. So they use other things called oil emulsions, products from endotoxins, cholesterol, fatty acids, paraffinic, and vegetable oils. You guys are aware, I'm sure, of the peanut allergies. Raise your hand if you know about the peanut allergies. Do you think this is some big, you know, mystery? What it is adjuvant 65 is a derivative of peanut oil, and it is put in many of the childhood vaccines. So here's baby. Baby goes in at 2 months, brand new little thing, and they get a little bit of injection of several vaccines that contain peanut oil. Well, guess what? Peanuts belong in the stomach and the gut. They don't belong in the blood system. They don't belong in the muscles. You know, our body goes through great measures to protect our blood and keep it pure. And here we are injecting deeply into the muscle, and it gets into the circulatory system. So the body sees peanut oil, and it attacks it. It doesn't belong there. And baby goes in every 2 months and gets a little bit more, and then mom feeds the baby a little peanut butter. And the child goes into full-blown anaphylactic shock. Or they have a severe asthma attack, or they swell up and they have hives. Or they're in severe gut inflammation and they're screaming and crying. So mom runs to the doctor, and the doctor says, oh, it's an allergic reaction. Let's give your baby some medication. You know, let's do something. We got to do it. Bring an antihistamine. Well, then it happens again and again, and the mother finds out the child is severely allergic to peanuts. But we don't know why. So now you can't have peanuts in school because so many children will drop dead in the presence of peanuts. And it's amazing to me that somehow all of this slips medical minds. Like, where did peanut allergies come from? Next slide. This is happening around the world. It's not just here. Our children now cannot eat gluten. They're intolerant to wheat and casein and cow and products from dairy because all of these things are put in vaccines. All of these byproducts are put in vaccinations. And so now we have a whole generation of children. And these autistic kids, they suffer with severe gut problems. And they cannot eat. Some of them can't eat 80, 90 foods that you and I grew up on. My daughter is a chiropractor. She's also the president of Heart for Autism and Hope for Autism, which is a bio-nutritional training program for physicians. We've held conferences educating doctors on how to heal children with autism. It can be done, but you have to deal and address with all of these issues in the gut. But you would be shocked how many children. She does allergy testing on kids, not just the little picky things. She does serious allergy testing. Some children are allergic to 90 foods that you and I grew up eating. And their parents don't realize that they're feeding them, and that's why their brains are in total brain fog. Remember, the gut and the brain are totally connected. And if you don't believe me, take a shot of whiskey on an empty stomach. Okay? You see the connection? Children with autism are suffering with brain fog because of what's going on in their gut and also the heavy metals that are in their system. Next slide. So peanut allergies are huge. Next slide. We'll get through that. Mineral compounds are used. Calcium phosphate, mineral salts, metals, nitrate, zinc, colloidal iron, oxide, all of these things are being injected when you get a vaccine. But aluminum, let's talk just about aluminum. You will be shocked when you find out how much aluminum. When they reduced the mercury, they had to increase something, and Dr. Sears wrote the alternative vaccine schedule. There's no such thing as a healthy alternative. I'm sorry. I've met Dr. Sears, and he and I agree to disagree, but you cannot have a healthy vaccine or a safe one. But the only study done ever on aluminum in infants was this one done here. Did you know that IV therapy food for babies who are born prematurely in the hospital is full of aluminum? So if a baby's born prematurely and they're getting IV food, they're getting huge amounts of aluminum. And they found a lot of renal kidney function problems with these newborn preemies. Anyway, one study all of these years is done on aluminum with infants. And they found that if a child, next slide, if a child gets the full amount of aluminum in their IV, they will have learning disabilities and signs of ADHD by 18 months. So, knowing that, and it's called the Aspen Study. You can look it up, Google it, it pops right up. But anyway, they found out that aluminum can build up to toxic levels in the bloodstream, bones, and brain. And they showed impaired neurological and mental development. Next slide. Well, and there's other follow-up studies that you can find on the internet. Next slide. So let's look at the aluminum level our children are getting, okay? By the way, the results of that study, they found that anything over 20 micrograms of aluminum injected into an infant can cause neurological developmental problems. So in case you can't see it, the first hepatitis B vaccine contains 250 micrograms of aluminum given day one in our hospital, and the DTaP has 625, which that's the diphtheria, pertussis, and tetanus vaccine, the HIP vaccine, the PCV, all of these contain high levels of aluminum. Remember, anything over 20 micrograms is considered unsafe. So, next slide. When a baby is fully vaccinated, they will get approximately 4,925 micrograms of aluminum through their vaccinations. Is that shocking to you? Next slide. I think it's terrible. Next slide. Dr. Sears basically said, I thought the studies had been done. To see how he said, I thought the studies had been done on aluminum and vaccines, but none have been done. What does that tell you? That tells you the safety studies have not been done on vaccinations. And any doctor who says that is ignorant and really does not know the facts. Journal of Autoimmunity now has a new syndrome. Go back to that last one, please. It's called ASIA. I don't know if you can do it. It's just the arrow up key on the far right. Anyway, it's called ASIA, autoimmune syndrome induced by adjuvants. 5 minutes, okay. Adjuvants, remember that. Auto-induced disease caused by adjuvants is now rampant and affecting this generation of children. They know the adjuvants are found in vaccines. Next slide. I have to get to this. You can look all of this up. It's the American Academy of Pediatrics has done studies on this, and they now know that this is a true issue with this generation of children. The mercury has not been removed. Next slide, we'll just go through this. All of this, by the way, I have a brochure you're going to see on my table up there, and I go into the aluminum, and I give you all the scientific references, and also the thimerosal vaccines. So if you don't get it here, I mean, get it out there. The National Institute of Health says ethyl mercury is more toxic than methyl mercury. Okay, next slide. You cannot compare, hit my buttons, I'm sorry, some of these have, you cannot compare eating a fish with mercury, with injecting it. We have a system in our body that chelates it out of our gut. But when you inject, that system is completely deactivated. Okay, so there's a whole difference between eating mercury in a fish and injecting it. And they tell pregnant women never to eat fish, right? And they tell nursing moms, don't eat fish, and yet we'll just inject it for you, you know, as though it's something good. This is the label off of the flu vaccine. This year's flu vaccine, Thimerosal, 25 micrograms of mercury. Keep going. Boyd Haley says, a single vaccine given to a 6-pound newborn is the equivalent of giving a 180-pound adult 30 vaccinations on the same day. Next slide. We're gonna have to go past all of this. Keep going. This is truly a CDC cover-up. The unfortunate truth is the CDC has known for many years that vaccines do cause autism. Keep going. What is a trace? I hear parents and doctors say, oh, there's just a trace, and it's a C. They actually said it's good for the body. What is a trace? 2 parts per billion, with a B, is the allowable amount in drinking water. 2 parts, okay? 200 parts per billion renders something toxic hazard waste. So they have to treat it like a toxic hazard waste. Fish, we know, now you can hit that again. Fish, we know, can have between 730 to 1400 micrograms of fish that you're eating. The first vaccination, the infant flu vaccine, contains 25,000 parts per million, and the adult vaccination for flu contains 50,000. So it's worse than toxic waste. Next slide. The EPA now is estimating that 1 in 6 children are born with high mercury levels. I wonder why. Next slide. Look on my website. Actually, keep going. I'm going to give you a website. This is the booklet I carry. My daughter, Dr. Renee Toko Hunter, and I made this, and it's on my desk. I encourage you to get it. Share it with people. When you do so, you support me. Polysorbate 80 is another adjuvant put in vaccines. We don't have time to go into this. Next slide. Keep going. Formaldehyde, we know formaldehyde is terrible. It's more hazardous than most chemicals. March, one of the most hazardous compounds in the ecosystem. It is not safe at any level. And yet we are injecting it into our babies when we give them vaccinations. It oxidizes into formic acid, which leads to acidosis and nerve damage. The liver and the kidney may also be damaged by it, and that's what's going on with renal dysfunction. Basically, vaccines are bioengineered in labs. You will never find a bird, pig, and other vaccination in nature. They're bioengineering these things and putting them together. I call it Franken-science, just like Franken-food. And then they're giving it to your children, and they wonder why we have so many sick kids. Keep going. 4 more minutes? Okay, I'll go. By the way, you know they use aborted fetal tissue now to develop vaccinations. Did you know that? So when you get a vaccine created on aborted fetal tissue, you're getting a little bit of it in your system, and the body attacks it. And that's what's leading to autoimmune problems, where the body is attacking itself because it's human tissue. It's called human diploid tissue. The rubella, chickenpox, MMR, and the hepatitis A vaccine are created on aborted fetal tissue. Next slide. If I took all of these things and injected them in an apple, would you eat it?
No.
I didn't hear you.
No.
Why is it okay to inject it? Next slide. Just some common sense, right? You can, by the way, my daughter and I just recently took over novaccine.com. I'm on the board, and I worked with the gentleman who created this incredible resource. It's the World Association for Vaccine Education. We just took it over. We're going to be updating it. But on this, you can go and pull up every vaccination by make and model, and you can look at the ingredients. You can click on the ingredients, and it'll take you to the scientific definition and also medical citations against it. Great website. Keep going. Know your rights. In every state in the country, we have some form of right to get out of vaccinations. Most people do not know this. Go ahead and hit it. This idea, no shots, no school, is not true. You just have to understand your rights. And if you don't, you're no different than a slave. On my website, go ahead. Childhood shots, I mentioned 3 different exemptions. I have a whole map of the United States where it will identify what your state rights are. So you can go to my website, childhoodshots.com, for that information. The growing trend is forced vaccinations. There are healthcare workers right now who are told, take the flu vaccine or get fired. As of just this week, somebody filed a class action lawsuit. I have no idea how it's going to turn out. But if you are a healthcare person, look up healthcare professionals for vaccine choice. And you can talk to me later at my thing. I helped form the group. American citizens will go to jail if they don't get their shots. Are you ready for this? It's a fact. There's already legislation signed in case we have a pandemic. If you don't vaccinate yourself and your children, you will go to jail and you will be fined $1,000 a day and your children will be vaccinated. This is the coming trend and I hope Sheriff Mack really addresses this. Keep going. I have something called the plan of action in relationship to the sheriff's power. You can skip past this. Just keep going, keep going, keep going. We're running out of time. Keep going, keep going. By the way, Bill Gates is behind a huge sterilization program. You can simply Google Bill Gates population control and vaccines and you can hear him saying with his own words that we must reduce the population. The way to do it is through better vaccination. Next slide. Most at risk are the pregnant women and the children. Next slide. Pediatric death is made worse by the flu vaccination. Keep going, next slide. Of course, keep going. Autism is no longer a mystery. They say it's been around forever. Where would the 2 million adults with autism be right now, if it's a fact? Most of the children are between the ages of 3 and 13 that have autism. This is a man-made, next slide. It's not better diagnosis, that's all a bunch of smoke screen, next slide. Keep going, right now it's 1 in 36 kids, or is it 36 boys? Keep going, we gotta pass all this up. Keep going, keep going. Oh, they have settled vaccine court. They have settled autism cases in vaccine court. Lots of them, but they don't tell the public. So anyway, the sobering fact is that we need to stop what we're looking at, next slide, and analyze it very carefully, even if, next slide, what we see is not pleasant. And I'm sorry, medical doctors and medical people out there, but you are the legal drug pushers who are doing this to our children. And you must be stopped. Next slide. Is this acceptable?
No.
Does it make you mad?
Yes.
Good. Get mad. I've been doing this since 1994. And you know what? I get madder as I go. But keep going. I have to keep my head. Next slide. We know that there are other environmental factors. I understand that. Go ahead and hit that button again. I'm not going to go into these. They're all the different environmental factors. There's food, there's chemicals, but we are injecting this stuff into children. I think it is the number one insult. Next slide. And it hit it a couple times. I'm not going to do this animated stuff in the future. Something's wrong. Next slide. I'm going to keep hitting it. Hit. Keep going, because there's something I want to get to. By the way, the purpose of the pediatrician is to indoctrinate your children into a lifelong dependency on medical interventions and drugs. There's no law that says you have to go to a pediatrician. I tell parents all the time, when you go there, say, I'm not vaccinating and see what happens. Okay? You do not have to go to a pediatrician. There are naturopaths, there are chiropractors, there are other doctors who will take care of you. More importantly, it's protect your children. And we have three epidemics, and I'm finishing with this. The first one is dangerous doctors who suffer from willful blindness. They refuse to see, they refuse to learn. Wherever I go across the country, I invite the state health department, I invite local pediatricians. They come, they sit in the back like this, and they don't have anything to say, okay? Willful blindness, next slide. The next one, of course, is it coming up? Is public ignorance. We have got to educate, educate, educate. If you injure our children neurologically, it doesn't matter what school they go to, it doesn't matter what job they have, they will not be able to function in society. This is the core of destroying our country from the children forward. Political corruption is at the base of it all. The next one is broken medical system that is designed to keep you sick. Okay, that's the whole purpose. This is the challenge. Anybody who thinks that vaccines are good, I want them to take all the vaccines that the infants are getting, all 38, and weight appropriate measures. And then we'll see if they can even function the next day. Next slide. My DVDs out there are vaccine safe. I go into a ton of information. It's two DVD set. Please, when you get this, you help me and you also can help family members. Next slide. Edmund Burke says, all that is needed for evil to succeed is that decent human beings do nothing. Next slide. You can hit it again. What's going on? Vaccines are safe, trust me. And there's the doctor. Thank you.